At a news conference last night, President Trump said there's a risk of foreign countries using mail-in ballots to cheat the election. He then accused the Democrats of doing their own election cheating without attempting to explain his allegation. Hogan Gidley joins me now. He's the national press secretary for the Trump campaign. Hogan, I delivered an opening commentary today essentially arguing that we've got this potential for a perfect storm brewing from now until election day or the final day of voting, comprised of the following: voting amidst a pandemic, an administrative overload, postal delay, and voter error because of newness with the absentee ballot process, which I think begs this question. Doesn't the president have an obligation to tell people that a delay in the count, I'm thinking about the night of November 3rd, is not indicative of fraud?
Well, a couple things. First of all, I appreciate you having me on. Thanks so much for the time. Also, I did watch your opening, and you make a lot of great points.
Good.
I mean, listen, here at the campaign, we are concerned about voter fraud in this election, in part because in so many states, Democrats are now suing to allow votes to come in after Election Day. Nevada is a great example of that. And so when you're talking about the potential for fraud, Nevada is going to be the poster child for it in this way. When they are going to send out 2 million ballots in the mail to their voters, they're also putting out envelopes that are prepaid with postage already on them. Now, the post office doesn't date those with a postmark because they're already prepaid. That means anyone could wake up on Wednesday morning, see that they don't like the results, and then go drop their ballots in the mail. It won't receive a postal date stamp on it, and so it has 3 days by Nevada law to actually get to the location of the courthouse and then to be counted. That is the potential for massive fraud, not to mention the fact if you mail it in before the date of the election and it is postmarked with a date, they still give you several days after that, 7 days, in fact, for it to count toward the candidate you want to. So the potential for the election to change days later in Nevada is very real. And that's one of the things we're most concerned about. It's the universal mail-in voting we're talking about. The absentee voting that they do in Florida and other states, the early voting they do, there are mechanisms and methods in place to make sure the person who's requesting the ballot is actually the person voting. But universal mail-in voting is a serious problem, and we're trying to expose
The Washington Post today has a headline, and maybe because it's the Post, you won't buy into it, but it sums it up this way. The likelier problem with mail voting delaying election results isn't fraud, it's confusion. Here, I'll give you an outlet you'd probably be more inclined to agree with. The lead editorial of today's Wall Street Journal, put this up on the screen. They run through all that went wrong in the New York election recently. But it ends this way, Hogan. It says, what a fiasco. Meantime, the national debate over mass mail voting proceeds like two postcards passing in the night. President Trump uses the word fraud. The factotums of conventional wisdom hit their computer hotkeys for phrases like no evidence of widespread fraud. Parenthetically, I tell you, that's what I was about to simply say to you. But let's see if we can agree on the next part. Why focus on criminality? Old-fashioned government incompetence is clearly sufficient to create a mail vote debacle the country might come to regret in November. What is the administration doing about that?
But it's not an either or, it's an and. I mean, for decades, you don't trust the post office with a greeting card to granny. Now you're telling them that the sacred vote you're trying to cast for president of the United States is going to go through the post office, and somehow we're supposed to trust that. You talked about delays. Absolutely, delays are a concern. You also talked about the article pointing out that in New York, two congressional districts, 6 weeks, I think one of them still they haven't certified yet. It took that long to find out who won the election.
Five states have done this. Five states have done this without any incident whatever. My concern here is protecting the sanctity and the perception of the ballot. And my complaint with the president is that when he lays this this predicate for fraud. He's setting up a dynamic where Americans on November 3rd are going to tune in looking at John King's magic wall and wonder, hey, why don't we have a victor tonight? That's not indicative of fraud. It's indicative of people voting absentee in the midst of a pandemic and the system not being able to count as quickly as they normally did. You get the final word.
First of all, there is rife fraud across this country in voting, and that's been proven time and time again in article after article. But what you're arguing here is there needs to be widespread fraud before we address fraud. That's absolutely ridiculous. And the states you were talking about who do mail-in voting, correct. They've been doing it for a long time. A couple of differences here. Democrats are trying to change the entire way we vote 3 months out before an election. And in four of the five states you just mentioned, the date specific means the ballot has to come in by 7 p.m. on election day. It doesn't allow for votes to come in afterwards. That not only sets up a situation for fraud, but it sets up a situation for massive delays, as we've discussed on this show.
But the insinuation, respectfully, the insinuation is that somehow the rules are being changed to grease the skids for a campaign against Donald Trump, without acknowledging we're amidst COVID-19, and people are going to be scared to death to stand in lines, and they need to be accommodated. So my suggestion for the president is simply that he begin talking about how we're going to pull this off because we're America, because we're first world, not third world, and it won't be suggestive of fraud if we don't know a victor until the fourth, fifth, or sixth. That's what I wanted to say.
No, and I understand that. But listen, we tried this in person in Wisconsin, and it worked. We expect a massive amount of people to vote in this election before Election Day because of absentee, because of mail-in. But to pretend as though there is no potential for fraud or that there won't be fraud when the rules are set up to allow fraud is just a head-in-the-sand mentality. We've got to make sure the election is free. We have to make sure the election is fair. That's what we want to do. And so we're exposing those states that are trying to upend the voting system this close to the election
but also
allow for votes legally after the date of the election. That's unacceptable.
Hogan, thanks. We'll continue.